I'm Samarendra Mohanty, president of Nanoscope Therapeutics.
Hi, I'm Sulagna, CEO of Nanoscope Therapeutics.
We are working on macular degeneration therapy using innovative ambient light sensitive opsin, which is basically targeted to bipolar cells, which is very near to photoreceptors. So in macular degeneration, you have geographic atrophy, especially in dry AMD. So instead of treating the genotype, we are trying to treat the phenotype, because there are a lot of gene mutation which can cause, or different factors which can cause macular degeneration, especially dry AMD. But we are targeting the phenotype where the patient develop slowly the geographic atrophic areas, and where there is light sensitivity is lost. So in those areas, we can make the bipolar cells photosensitive again by introducing a gene through a viral vector or other means that is in our pipeline, and that makes it ambient light sensitive. So once light falls on those bipolar cells, and they will generate current similar to what happens in natural environment, and transmit that through ganglion cells to the brain. So we have done experiments on different animal models, retinal degenerated animal models, and shown promising results on those. And we are going through the cGMP manufacturing to translate it to clinical trial. So we are initially thinking of going for advanced dry AMD or RP, retinal pigmentosa patients, to do later this year or early next year, and then after that we'll go to the wider populations where you need to actually deliver the genes into specific areas. So that will be next year. So we are introducing the gene initially through AAV vector, which have been shown to be safe in animal model. This is adeno-associated virus. It packages the gene and it delivers through intravitreal or subretinal injection, depending on if you are going for widespread all over the retina there is photoreceptor degeneration, then we are going through intravitreal. But if it has to be localized, then we are going through other means, either subretinal and other means that is in our pipeline. So once you inject, that virus or the molecule goes to specific cells, and this gene has a promoter which will target to specific cell type.
So. Oh yeah, Nanoscope was founded in 2009, and we started working on ocular therapy, and then we came up with our own opsin over the time, which is completely in-house developed. And we have excellent scientific as well as business development team in our company. We have been enormously funded by National Institute of Health and NEI. We are grateful for their support and encouragement. And I'm really proud of my team. Our scientific people are amazing, as well as our business development team, our advisors. We have distinguished advisors who has been guiding us to, which laid our path up to this mark, and we are hoping to start the clinical trial early next year. So all our preclinical studies are almost done. Now we are streamlining our IND preparation and hoping to file the IND sometime this year. We have already got orphan designation for RP. So our initial route is for RP, and then we will broaden our path for dry AMD, because as we are working on the phenotype, not particular gene or genotype, so we have broader market to reach, and we see promising result for dry AMD mice model. Well, all the information will be published on our website, which is nanostherapeutics.com. So I really appreciate people to visit our website. We keep on updating all our news, our data, our clinical trial. When we get the approval from FDA to start, definitely everything will be updated over there.
Yeah, we have other products in pipeline. So we are thinking of having the laser gene delivery method that is still in preclinical stage. So that is our second for specific targeted expression of the gene. I was telling one method is subretinal injection, the other one is a, we have a unique method whereby laser we can deliver the gene to specific areas, targeted areas. So that's very unique for us. But we are still making it, you know, perfect in the animal model before we move.